story arc two-parter called Hello, Old Fen. We found out about the whereabouts of Titanium Knight. Navi gave a prediction, Line Swordsman Power. After the swordsman of the Armada came to help Prince Vakar, he became overconfident and wants to be in the front line as well as to confront the Rangers. One of Vakar's minions, Argus, uses the same attack as Titanium Knight had used. Troy recognized that fighting style. Turns out, Argus is Kreepox, resurrected by the Armada through the use of the Titanium Header, original form of Troy's friend, Titanium Knight. This shocked Troy. Kreepox's rivalry with Troy had returned. Troy wants to turn Titanium Knight back to normal, yet failing frequently as Kreepox is in charge of the cyborg. Kinda ironic how Kreepox, who turned Troy into a cyborg, ended up being a cyborg himself. But the reunion was shortened after Troy was stunned. Orion stepped in to protect Troy from being blasted before Argus delivered a powerful blow which badly damaged Orion. Orion blasted at Argus and the Prince. The Prince was badly wounded and Argus lost his sword. Melkor ordered for an immediate retreat. While Orion was recovering, using a natural remedy suggested by Navi from Princess Shayla, Troy left to meet Argus. The two dueled while the other Rangers fought against the elite swordsman general. Argus says he does not remember anything of his life as Kreepox or Titanium Knight. His allegiance is to his master, Prince Vakar. Troy tried to remind Argus with a sword style that Titanium Knight had taught him, but to no avail. The duel ended with Argus easily defeating a depressed Troy. Troy's morale was crushed because Kreepox has taken everything away from him. His love, his life, his body, and now even Titanium Knight. But as Troy touches his Morpher and Ranger Key, he saw that even though his past is all taken away, he still has friends to look forward to. Friends who trust him, who puts their faith in him. Troy returns to join the Rangers, relinquishing himself from any self-doubt. His arc of acceptance of himself and his side by his friends are over. At this point, when the Rangers morphs into Samurai, Troy was able to summon the Samurai Double Disc received from the Samurai Rangers. With the power of bonds and trust towards each other, the Red Line Zord was touched by this, and together, the Fury Line and the Rangers were able to unleash their hidden powers from the Samurai Double Disc. With the team's strong bonds, they were able to create the Wild Samurai Pirate Zord to defeat the monster. In a filler-ish episode called Robot Reprogram for Blue, Navi gave a prediction. Pizza time, delivery, not takeout. Not to one of the most infamous Power Rangers episode, it's a tribute to Power Rangers Turbo. Justin Stewart, now a grown man, stepped into this dimension to visit the Rangers and help the Pirate Rangers. Meanwhile, on the command ship of the Armada, we were introduced to a new character called Invidious. He is a slave and cook of the Armada. He's been forced to work under the Armada. He was never interested in fighting. He was hoping to land, sneak onto Earth, leave the Armada, and learn about Earthland cuisines. Invidious made a tea filled with nanorobots programmed for mind control, hoping it will allow Metal Alice to set him free. However, it accidentally reprogrammed Metal Alice to love the first thing she ever saw. She saw Justin through observing the Rangers' progress and immediately wanted Justin to be her husband. Invidious made a deal with her, trading Justin for Invidious' freedom. Justin Stewart has become an inventor and worked alongside with Ethan from Dino Thunder. The two provided a lot of equipment used by SPD in the future. He was there to check out the Rangers' equipment. However, Invidious was sent there to capture him. The Rangers tries to protect him. As a joke, the Rangers morph into Operation Overdrive, which looks like a car series just like Turbo. But Justin said, that is not Power Rangers Turbo. So the Rangers transformed into Power Rangers Turbo instead to rescue Justin. After Invidious was defeated, the nanobot reprogramming was broken and Metal Alice was no longer interested in Justin. But Metal Alice stared at Troy for a bit before retreating. Something is stirring inside her. Dr. Carver joked, maybe Metal Alice is into Troy. Justin Stewart from Turbo provides a flying zord, the Scorching Cyclone Turbo Zord, to help the Rangers in aerial combats. But unfortunately, this Turbo toy was still in production, so it was not sent there until the finale of the season. Orion did have a special bond with Justin. Orion recognizes Justin and said how much he's grown. Justin did recognize Orion too, saying he's surprised that Orion is finally not invisible. This will be explored further on. Emma used this episode to show Troy how love can be easily taken away if it was just a program. If Troy did not have a heart to love, it would have been easily gone. After seeing how much Troy fought its programming, Troy do still have feelings to his girlfriend. This pain proving he is Troy, not computer codes of the Armada. As it later turns out, the fight destroys the Armada's tracking chip with Invidious, who is freed by the Rangers, and he is not destroyed. He disguises himself as human. Now, off onto his adventure to become the next Gordon Ramsay. Navi gave a vague prediction yet again. Not these Orions, but that Orion over there is dangerous. And the two-parter called From Sinister in the Sixth and Auxiliary with Evil, Anatu Titanium Rangers from Deep in the Shadows, and Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, Green Rangers, Green with Evil, Orion has a secret. Orion is from the planet Triforia, where Orion can split into three beings. Orion of Courage, Orion of Heart, and Orion of Wisdom. Orion believes through splitting up into three beings, he could learn the Morphin Grid faster. While Orion has been practicing, Orion of Wisdom taps into the forbidden areas of the Morphin Grid, where there were remnants of evil powers, specifically, the Sixth and Auxiliary Ranger powers. Orion of Wisdom was corrupted by the powers and has transformed into a monstrous form called Viginti. Orion of Courage and Orion of Heart realize how dangerous the Morphin Grid can be, decides to unite together and stay as one being, to avoid corruption. Seeing Orion of Wisdom can never be returned, both sides declared arch-nemesis of each other. Viginti actually uses the same suit as Kamen Rider Wizard because the Morphin Grid feels like magic merged with technology. Orion cannot destroy Viginti. If he destroyed a part of himself, he will no longer become a soiled being, but become a pure energy being, which he would die without a proper mystical container, similar to Zordon and Gosei. Viginti wants to harness the entire Morphin Grid and become the new darkness of Supreme Master of the Underworld. He wants all the Ranger powers for himself to restore the Alliance of Evil and become the next Dark Spectre. He learned to harness and produce a bunch of 6 Ranger and extra Ranger keys. Weird enough, Viginti actually produced a titanium knight key. Viginti can summon ranger puppets to do his biddings from his ranger keys. Viginti has a personal favorite key, the titanium ranger, which acts as his bodyguard, butler, and assistant. It was used all the time. In Gokaiger, Vasco has Sally. In this case, titanium ranger acted as Viginti's Sally. Titanium ranger key is the first sentient ranger key that was constructed by Viginti. He has turned the ranger key into a doorway to the underworld. He can use the Titanium Ranger Key power to summon giant demons to battle the Rangers, probably from the same ones from the Demon Realm of Lightspeed Rescue. In his first outing, Viginti kidnapped Orion's team and demands Orion to hand over the Ranger Keys. Orion was able to trick Viginti in returning his friends without handing the keys over. He hid a Morpher inside the treasure box filled with keys, threw it to his teammates. Dr. Carver caught the Morpher with his mouth, and Troy grabbed a Ranger Key, put it in the Morpher's keyhole. Dr. Carver morphed into Green Lightspeed Rescue Ranger and freed the team, while Viginti tried to collect the scattered Ranger Keys as the Rangers were busy finding the Ranger Key clones. Navi collected the keys before Viginti could do anything. However, Viginti didn't care much for now because he wants Orion to power up the keys to their fullest potential through the help of veteran Rangers. Currently, the keys are insufficient in powers and require past Ranger teams' ultimate powers. The powers bestowed to the Megaforce team were added to the Ranger keys as well. Viginti announces he will be hunting down for the ultimate powers that were not collected yet, and Orion should hurry up to collect them before Viginti takes it all to himself. Orion told Viginti he needs to master veteran Ranger checkpoints to gain the power. There is no shortcut. Viginti responded he already has. He was held inside the Morphin Grid for over a decade. To Orion, it might be a few months ago since he was sealed. Since Orion has time traveled to the future, Viginti was healthier throughout all this time. That's how he learned all the powers. Navi gave a new prediction. Silver is the new black. Later in the following episode, Silver Light. The team was having a stalemate with the monster of the day who was using an energy field. Not even the new Six Ranger powers could take him down. While the team retreated back to the skyship, Orion meditated to see if they could find a way to defeat the new monster. He was meditating into the Morphin Grid as a daily ritual to power up the keys. He found Jake lost in limbo within the Morphin Grid in his meditation. He asked Dr. Carver to help him see if this is true. Turns out it was confirmed. Jake is in the Morphin Grid, still alive but in a coma state. Orion uses the 6 Ranger Key powers he had acquired from battle to pull Jake out. When Orion pulls Jake out of the Morphin Grid, Jake's Gosei Morpher was altered by the fighting spirits of the 6 Rangers, creating a new 6 Ranger Morpher. Orion immediately hands Jake the Silver Key given to him by Sky earlier. The Silver Key reacts to him and creates the Silver Pirate Ranger Key. Jake becomes Pirate Silver. The Rangers try to keep Jake up to speed, but Jake says that since he was in the Morphin Grid for a while, he has seen all the history of Power Rangers up to this time, including the Pirate Rangers, and he knows all about Orion as well. Jay tested out his powers and took down the newest monster that had an impenetrable shield, where all five rangers were no match against Pryor. Also, Prince Vicar sacrificed the general of the day by planting a bomb in the shield, which when touched, it will blow up the rangers and the monster together. When he revealed this to Malcor, he was shocked by that move, because he sees every single subordinate is important. Since Jake lives inside the morphing grid for nearly a long period of time, he has knowledge of Power Rangers history. Recognizing all past rangers, he sees them, fanboying all over the cameos. Basically, a Power Rangers fan in Power Rangers. There was also a running gag that Jake asked for signatures and selfies with the veteran rangers. He also tries to give lectures about the history of Power Rangers, but Troy, Gia, and Orion were never interested. Navi gave a new prediction, colonists from Earth invites. Then remembering about the veteran's reward for Jake, the team decides to split up. Jake could test out his powers while everyone could look up on prophecy for Earthling colonists. Jake looked for the Quantum Ranger Key, Mighty Morphin Green Ranger Key, and Dino Thunder White Ranger Key. The keys gave him intuition on how to use it. Before Jake could test out his powers, he was interrupted by the scientist of the week testing out Xborgs. The other ranger shows up to help Jake. There was a gag where Jake wants to use the Samurai Ranger keys, but his belt buckle isn't connected to the treasure box, so he needs Orion to pass him a key. Jake says the 6th Samurai Ranger key is the Gold Ranger with the symbol power written on the face. Orion passes Jake the Zeo Gold Ranger key. Jake realizes it's wrong and Orion correctly gave him the Gold Samurai Ranger key instead. They later morph into Silver Rangers. After the scientist was defeated, it grew into a giant. Jake decides it's time to test out his new Zord. As hinted in the last season, Jake was bestowed the Quantum Flyer that was sent by Time Force team in the future, which was designed by Trent and Tommy Oliver from Dino Thunder. It has three different modes, Quantum Flyer Drill Mode as a default, which is the tribute to Time Force, and the next mode, Dragon Mode, which is a tribute to Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Dragon Sword. The final mode would be the Thundersaurus Mode, a tribute to Dino Thunder Megazord, which also looks very suspicious in looking like the Mighty Morphin Megazord. It helped Orion achieve victory at ease. In a character building episode called the Armor of Six, since Jake was stuck in the morphing grid for a while, he has the ability to merge ranger powers together. Dr. Carver asked if Jake has been corrupted by the morphing grid like Viginti, but Gia defended Jake, said he heroically got absorbed into it while Viginti entered it while he was corrupted already. This led to Dr. Carver's suspicion of Jake at first, then later resentment, because Dr. Carver felt he's overlooked and has inferiority complex. Dr. Carver took years of training and understanding of the ranger powers to help Orion forge their pirate powers, but it took Jake merely a second to merge the RPM gold and silver keys together. The two later worked together and settled their differences after the rest of the team were defeated by the monster of the day. Dr. Carver inspired Jake to produce the season's Battleizer, Jake's Gold Mode. In the next episode, Dr. Carver was out for groceries and he stumbled upon Viginti, who sent the Titanium Ranger key to attack Dr. Carver. Viginti retreated after the rest of the team shows up. We get a tribute called Destined for Magnitude. Caron and Diamond from Lost Galaxy contacted Dr. Carver through his phone and gave them the coordinates on where to meet, but Viginti intercepted the message and was there at Maranoia right in front of the Invisi Portal. He summons Ranger Key powers to fight the Rangers while heading to Caron and Diamond first.